Myself, Dr. Amarnath Shetty, professor in the IT Civil Department, Mangalore. We will go for water supply and treatment engineer. I will explain now. Reverse osmosis, salt passage and rejection. The basic understanding of reverse osmosis process is flow is necessary to fully appreciate salt passage and rejection. An RO membrane system is comprised of three fluid streams: the feed, the permit, and concentrate. As the feed water passes through the membrane, as a result, permitted product water and concentrate reject water are produced. Unless there was a significant leak in the system, the combined volume of permits and concentrate will always equal to feed flow volume, as shown in the calculation. Feed flow, permitted flow, and concentration flow. Okay, feed flow equal to permitted flow plus concentration flow. For the designation as Q, feed flow QF, permitted flow QP, concentrated flow QC, overall the mass equation is equal to QF into CF equal to QP into CP plus QC into CC. C referring to the concentration in the streams. Okay. While there is a fully accountability of the water volume in the RO process, the feed water, okay, the feed water will also be found in either resulting permitted or concentrated streams. Okay, the percentage compound that passes through the RO varies layer and substrate. Okay, found in permitted and described as the salt passage. The compound that do not pass through the RO barrier layer and found in the concentration are considered to be rejected. Okay, to be rejected, which process is called passage. Okay, permit found is a salt passage. We do not pass is rejected. The term passage is the reciprocal of the term rejection. Okay, salt that salt transport. Okay, transport or lack of transport through the membrane barrier layer is described as salt rejection and inverse to salt passage. Example of this equation, salt passage is equal to Cp by Cf into 100. Okay, permitted TDS is equal to Cp, feed water TDS designated as Cf, concentrated TDS is equal to Cc. Salt rejection 1 minus salt passage into 100. If an RO feed the water concentrate permits the TDS of 10 ppm and a feed water TDS 2000 ppm. Okay, the salt passage would be calculated as 10 by 1000 into 100 equal to 1%. Salt rejection would be calculated as 1 minus 0.01 into 199%. Okay, salt passage will be calculated as 10 by 1000 into 100 equal to 1%. Salt rejection would be calculated as 1 minus 0.01 into 199%. Okay. Flux or water flux. The flux or water flux is typically expressed as a volume per area per unit time. Flux is to express the rate at which water permits the reverse osmosis membrane. Typical unit of measurement are gallons per square foot per day, GFD, okay, or liter per square meter per hour. Okay, the flux of a RO membrane is directly proportional to the temperature and pressure as rule of thumb flux decreased by the amount of 1.5% per 1% 1 degree Fahrenheit. Yes, okay. The salt flux is the amount of TDS that passed through a given area of membrane per unit of time. It is important to remember the salt flux function concentrate gradient and not drain pressure. Therefore, with the increase of drain pressure, the concentration of salt permit decrease due to the concentrated salt leakage, okay, milligram, and increased water flux liter. The net effect of increased drive pressure to dilute a constant amount of salt with more pure water. Okay, concentration polarization. Concentration polarization referred to be concentration gradient of the salt on the higher pressure side of the reverse osmosis membrane surface created by the less than intermediate reduction of salt left, okay, behind as water permits to the membrane itself. The salt concentration in the boundary layer exceeds the concentration of bulk water. This phenomena impacts the performance of reverse osmosis process, increases osmotic pressure at the membrane surface, leading to the following, okay, reduce the flux, okay, increase the salt leakage, increase the probability of the scaled up. Okay, nanofiltration member having a nominal pore size of approximately 0.001 micron and a MWCO of 1000 to 10,000 1 lakh delta. Pushing water through this smaller membrane porous requires a higher operation pressure, either MF or UF. Operating pressure nearly 600 kPa and can be a high as 1000 kPa. This system can be removed vertically. All the crushed bacteria, virus, and humic materials. They provide excellent protection from DBP formation. It is the disinfectant reduced the added after membrane filtration step. Because nanofiltration membrane also remove the alkalinity, the product of water can be corrosive and measure such a blending raw water and a product of water or adding alkalinity may be needed to reduce the corrosivity. Nanofiltration also remove the hardness of the hardness from the water, which account of nanofiltration membrane sometimes is called softening membrane. Okay, hard water treated by nanofiltration will pre-treatment to avoid the precipitation of hardness ion on the membrane. However, okay, more energy for nanofiltration than okay membrane filtration, okay, or ultrafiltration. Nanofiltration membrane nominal, it is a very this one, okay, which filter water, okay, which pushes water through the smaller membrane for required higher operation pressure either. Okay, nanofiltration or ultrafiltration, okay, membrane filtration or ultrafiltration. Operating pressure usually 6 PPa, 600 kPa. Okay, higher version than the ultrafiltration or membrane filtration. Okay, because of nano membrane filtration also remove the alkalinity. This provide the water corrosion can be product of water can be corrosion and measure the such blending of water. Okay, this is very important. Overall, overview of reverse osmosis and nanofiltration. Okay, The water, raw water or waste water in particular, the configuration of the industrial RO or NF system can be depend upon the application and characteristics of water in the reaction of the required level purity. Okay, purity. Though each system is typically unique and custom designed, okay, inlet collection water, okay, R1 nano filtration membrane system can be sometimes inlet collection tank, feed pumps, skid and tank, filtration system, membrane or module rack, receiving tank, okay, back wash pumps of receiving tank of for MF and UF, chemical cleaning system, compressed air for scoring the membrane when MF and UF is clean, automation instrumentation, okay, the inlet collection tanks feed to pumping system that normally two pumps, enabling the system to be run continuously 24 hours a day. Okay, the water then flows to the holding tank large enough for half hour to half an hour worth of influence. Depend upon the nature of feeding feed streams. If the feed stream has a lot of variability to it, the tank might be pulled more in order to give the streams time blend out the up and downs of the feed source. From this water flow through the pre-filter to take out the filter large enough plug the internal fiber and ultrafiltration filter, which is usually type of strainer, though there are different types of design. From this we get the feed of ultrafiltration system, which reduce the suspended particles, bacteria and virus from going into RO. Okay, it is offered to clean several times a day with the black flushing and chemical cleaning to keep modules centralized. Okay, synthesized. Every once in a while, CIP with the chemical cleaning is performed once in a month or quarter. Once in a quarter, cleaning skid should be included with the UF RO NF membrane system along with the backwash of cleaning pump, air store and air blower. After UF permits it collected holding tank. Okay, the purpose of a holding tank have two functions. It is used for backwash of filter. It also used for forward flow of RO unit. The RO has a cartilage filter housing and followed by the membrane array specifically designed of that application. The typical array is not 2 by 1, where the water kind is different arrays. Okay, they are all designed comprised the modeling tools depending upon the facility required to flow. Okay, from this over the water goes to holding tank and subsequently amount storage capacity store enough water still the take the RO down and clean it. It is designed to handle the peak flow of the production. So if you have the production that need 1 lakh gallons per day, you use the water over 16 hours, then storage tank need have enough water cover 16 hours of consumption. Next are the boost of the pumps of the water holding.